进来！
司机，你快点让开！你把这种难度高的让我来。呜、
哦！这是什么路线啊？啊！
哇！Is the autonomous driving assistance system of domestic brand stronger or Tesla FSD from overseas stronger? Is the Huawei or Xiaomi stronger in the competition of assistant driving? Use the most popular cars to challenge the most difficult scenarios. In this episode of Bigger Box, we have brought three mid-large SUVs that combine intelligence and performance. The Luxeed R7, equipped with the Huawei's Qianqun ADS 3.3.2 intelligent assistant driving system and the two-link platform. Xiaomi YU7, the first to launch a 10 million clips version of the assistant driving system. And the Tesla Model Y, which is equipped with the FSD and actively invest comparison with peer companies. These three models are unavoidable choices when people consider mid-to-large SUVs, and their assistant driving system are also products developed by manufacturers with hundreds of millions of costs. So what is the actual experience like? We conducted tests on the three models in both urban navigation and active safety aspects. Since only older Tesla models can currently enable FSD, we will use the older Tesla Model Y for the urban navigation segment and the new Model Y for the active safety testing segment. The performance at intersections most directly affects the correctness of the leading route. We have selected some representative intersections, which are generally more difficult, and the passing situation is shown in the figure. All three cars easily pass through the asymmetrical street intersections. The key is that the amplitude and the timing of the steering were appropriate, resulting in a good driving experience. For unprotected left turns, the three vehicles have a relatively sensitive response to the non-motor vehicle shuffling through. And when it comes to the need to enter the dedicated lane for the right turn, both the Luxeed R7 and the Xiaomi YU7 move as easily as if they were going home. But Tesla Model Y seems a bit out of place. After smoothly entering the dedicated right turn line, its large body tries to rush into the small non-motorized lane, which is a result of the cultural ignorance between the East and the West. And the FSD, which is born in the US, still can't react when it sees the non-motor vehicle lanes in China.
哎，接管。
And in the U-turn scenarios, all three mid-large SUVs performed well. And Tesla is a bit special. The steering wheel turns very smoothly and somewhat similar to the manual turn bad driver. However, it is the only one among the three cars that cannot recognize the turn waiting area. And this road about the intersection is not long, so the difficulty lies in that we need to turn left at the exit and enter the correct lanes within a short distance. And here, only the Xiaomi YU7 was a bit slow when it came out and drove into the right turn lane nearby. The other two cars both smooth entered and exit the roundabout and turn left. In the bifurcation scenario, the growth lines were unclear and somewhat confused, but the Luxeed R7 and Tesla Model Y entered the correct lens very clearly and decisively. And our streamlined acceleration king Xiaomi was confused here and want to charge forward, but we put back bad driver. In addition, the assistant driving functions of the three models, Luxeed R7, Xiaomi YU7, and Tesla Model Y, has stronger coverage and inclusiveness for roads. For example, narrow cobblestone alleys, commercial food area without landmarkings, pedal arch bridges over lakes, and remote villages can basically all activate the function with a very high coverage rate. And looking at the lane selection, the Xiaomi YU7 is the fastest among the three vehicles, always reaching the finish line first, but sometimes it fails to change lines in time, leading to the risks for crossing the salt line. So most of the maneuvers of Tesla FSD are quite smooth, but it will occasionally perform some inexplicable operations. For example, when driving street normally, it somehow wants to follow other vehicles. The Luxeed R7 has the most balanced overall performance and with no abnormal behavior throughout the journey. And in fact, previous versions used to have a problem to miss intersections due to the pursuit of efficiency. But now the planning and control are more reasonable, and the adjustment of speed to enter the target lane is smoother. And let's take another look at the ability of the three cars to handle various obstacles on the road. And the basic detours are well executed, such as those around the pedestrians, non-motorized vehicles, and temporarily parking cars. And the timing and space for detour are also well grasped when there are oncoming vehicles. The Luxeed R7 when facing a bus also demonstrated the quality of an expensive driving. Its reaction speed when bypassing the bus is almost indistinguishable from that of the human driving, and it can also slow down in time when there is oncoming traffic, then proceed after ensuring safety. The Tesla following in behind also quickly chose the bypass. But when facing high-density obstacle areas, the performance of the three completely different. First up is Tesla Model Y, and there is no doubt about its overall perceptions, capabilities. But it comes immobile when it gets a bit too close to people. This has also been a long-standing characteristic of Tesla FSD. In the US, this approach has no issues, achieving good yielding effects and usually getting people around to quickly leave. But facing with a situation of many pedestrians shuttling around and the mixing of people and vehicle in China, Tesla really can handle it. Another issue is that FSD seems a bit near-set. It attempts to bypass the main basket on the right, but due to the limitations on the left, it fails to create a significant distance. When it gets closer, it becomes unsure and almost ran over the main basket. The Luxeed R7's performance is even more mature, and weaving left and right at slow speed and navigating through crowd. Xiaomi sensitivity is in the middle, and its avoidance performance is acceptable. But when encountering an oncoming vehicle with a slightly faster speed, YU7 gets nervous. Additionally, we encountered a section of road construction on the way. And let's take a look at how the three cars' performance when dealing with cone blocking the road. Both Tesla Model Y and Xiaomi YU7 were among the first to take action to change lane and avoid, where Luxeed R7 was just blocked by the vehicle in front. but when the vehicle in front cut out halfway and revolves a bit off the cone, there is an immediate response, which is very sensitive. And when assistant driving function is not activated, how much protection can the active safety system of the three models provide to the vehicle owners? And we went to the professional enclosed testing ground and recreated 5 high frequency risk scenarios. And the test results are as shown in the figure. And the first time, the stationary water barrier belongs to the National Standard Project, with testing starting at 35 km and the upper limit of 122 km per hour. And the AEB of Xiaomi YU7 and Tesla Model Y showed no response at all. Only the Luxeed R7 can achieve stable braking even at a speed of 125 km per hour. It can be observed that the Luxeed R7 tend to the trigger AEB relatively late at low speed, such as 35 to 55 km per hour. And however, when the speed increases to the next range, the trigger point becomes significantly earlier. At a speed of 125 km per hour, it provides early warnings and brakes. And therefore, its AEB is less likely to be falsely triggered. And at the same time, it determines AEB based on its own vehicle speed and the necessary braking distance. The logic of this trigger point is very reasonable. It was also because of this project that Tesla directly caused us to lose 24,000 yuan. Tesla's AEB function has no reaction to water barriers, but its standard pedestrian protection device is very sensitive. Once it pops open, all relevant components must be replaced, and the repair cost is expensive. Here we want to speak for Tesla owners and hope that the manufacturers can optimize the pedestrian protection device as soon as possible, such as reducing the maintenance cost and other operations. And therefore, the subsequent AEB project will switch to a new Model Y. However, due to the pedestrian protection device, testers were operating under extreme conditions, anticipating that the AEB function would fail and then manually avoiding collisions. All data should be used as a reference at your discretion. The second item, daytime adult crossing, has been incorporated into a latest national standard, but it will not be implemented until 2028. Tesla triggered braking at a speed of 35 km per hour, but it was very late, almost at the same point as when the driver decided to manually perform extreme avoidance. And both Xiaomi YU7 and Luxeed R7 has achieved obstacle avoidance at high speed. With Luxeed R7 once again braking to a stop at a speed of 125 km per hour. Additionally, when manufacturers implement the AEB function, considering anti-rear end collision, it is common for the AEB to release after triggering a brake stop. The daytime diagonal crossing of non-motorized vehicles restores the traffic characteristics of some region in China. Tesla Model Y and Xiaomi YU7 has warning but cannot brake to avoid obstacles. The Luxeed R7 can issue warning, brake, and a stop, and avoid collisions at a speed of 105 km per hour.
Okay!
And at 115 km per hour, it will also issue warning and apply braking, but the braking force is insufficient, resulting in a collision. The children suddenly darting out in the nighttime braking light is the most difficult item, where a children dash out from behind an obstacle vehicle at a speed of 5 km per hour with a collision point of 15%, and the oncoming lights are extremely blinding, make it difficult for drivers. And in this scenario, Tesla shows no reactions.
自己来的，自己踩的吧。
我踩的。
The Xiaomi YU7 can come to a stop at 55 kilometers per hour.Issues a warning and the active hazard lights at 65 km per hour and also triggers braking, but insufficient brake force may lead to a collision. The Luxeed R7 can brake to a stop at 65 km per hour. Issues a warning and flash hazard lights at 75 km per hour.And also triggers braking, but inefficient braking force will result in a collision. Both cars perform well. After all, in this low visibility environment, people generally drive at a slow speed. The situation of the leading vehicle cutout and encounters the stationary rear of the front vehicle usually occur on the highway. So our starting test speed is 80 km per hour. The Xiaomi YU7 can issue a warning and brake to a stop at 80 km per hour, but it will release the brake after stopping. Therefore, in case the vehicle owners encounters this situation, remember to apply the braking again.And when traveling at 100 km per hour, Xiaomi YU7 will also trigger AEB braking, but insufficient braking will result in a collision. The Tesla Model Y can issue a warning and brake to a stop at 80 km per hour, and it performs well, with a braking system providing a great sense of reassurance.At 100 km per hour, there is a warning, but the braking point is too late, so the driver chooses to manually avoid this situation. The Luxeed R7 triggers AEB braking to avoid obstacles at both 80 km per hour and 100 km per hour.At speed of 120 km per hour, the system anticipates that the braking distance is insufficient to stop and directly trigger EAS, which means that when the vehicle detected a collision risk, but braking alone cannot avoid the collision, EAS will control the vehicle to steer to lateral avoidance while performing emergency braking. The Luxeed R7 ultimately decelerates while also steering to avoid obstacles.We also attempt a test speed of 130 km per hour, which also triggered the AES safety avoidance. The overall performance of the active safety sections shows that the Luxeed R7 maintained the consistent high speed and high standard performance of the Huawei system. Xiaomi has also made significant progress after upgrading to the new version, but Tesla has not yet exerted much effort on the AEB function. After this test, it's not hard for everyone to notice that the availability of urban pilot assist is rising rapidly, and the system can already handle most road sections, thereby helping drivers reduce fatigue. However, risks usually occur in an instance, and sometimes pilot assistant or AEB can handle them, bringing the safety redundancy of human vehicle door insurance. But there are definitely situations they can't handle. Drivers should focus on driving and make reasonable use of the value of the assistant driving system. And after watching this video, which do you think performed the most satisfactorily among Luxeed R7, Xiaomi YU7, and Tesla Model Y?Does the performance of the latest versions of Luxeed R7 and Xiaomi YU7 exceed your expectations? And waiting for your answer in the comment section.